Welcome to a lesson on Dijkstra's algorithm. When you visit a website like Google Maps or use your smartphone for driving directions, you're usually looking for a shortest path between two locations. These computer applications use representations of the street maps as graphs, with the estimated driving times as edge weights. Often it is possible to find a shortest path on a small graph by using guess and check. However, our goal is to develop methods to solve complex problems in a systematic way by following algorithms. An algorithm is a step-by-step procedure for solving a problem. Dijkstra's algorithm will find the shortest path between two vertices. And here are the steps we'll follow. Number one, we'll mark the ending vertex with a distance of 0, designate this vertex as current. Two, we'll find all the vertices leading to the current vertex, calculate their distances to the end. Since we already know the distance to the current vertex is from the end, this will just require adding the most recent edge. We don't record this distance if it is longer or larger than a previous recorded distance. Three, we'll mark the current vertex as visited. We will never look at this vertex again. And then four, we mark the vertex with the smallest distance as current and repeat from step two. Finally, five, stop once you found the shortest distance from the starting to the ending vertex. So let's take a look at an example. We want to find the shortest path between vertices A and G using the graph. So we're going to work backwards from G and find the shortest path to A, though it really wouldn't matter if we started with A and find the shortest path to G. So we'll mark vertex G with a 0, indicating it's 0 units from the end, and we'll also label G as current. Now we'll look at all the vertices that lead to G, which should be E and F in this case. We'll notice E would be 7 units from G, so we'll label E with a 7. And notice that F is 6 units from G, so we'll label F with a 6. So now we can mark G as visited. So we'll say this means it's visited. And because 6 is less than 7, vertex F is now current. And now we'll look at all the vertices that lead to F. Notice that E leads to F, but since 6 plus 2 is 8, and we already have E labeled with 7, we won't record this value. But D also leads to F, and since 6 plus 4 is equal to 10, we'll label D with 10 to represent D is 10 units from the end. C also leads to F. Notice 6 plus 5 is 11, so we'll mark C as 11. Now we can mark F as visited. So looking at vertex E, D, and C, since E is the least distance from the end, E is now current. And now we'll look at all the vertices leading to E, which should be B and D because we already visited F. First, looking at vertex B, notice 7 plus 6 is 13. So we label vertex B with 13, meaning it's 13 units from the end. Now looking at vertex D, notice how 7 plus 2 would be 9, which is less than 10. So we replace 10 with 9, meaning if we take this path, D is only 9 units from the end. We mark E as visited. Looking at vertex B, D, and C, notice how D is the least distance from the end, so D is current. And now we look at the vertices leading to D, which should be B and C. Looking at B first, notice how 9 plus 3 would be 12. Because 12 is less than 13, we replace 13 with 12. Looking at C, notice that 9 plus 2 is 11. Since C is already marked with 11, we can go ahead and leave that as 11. Mark D as visited. Looking at vertices B and C, because 11 is less than 12, C is now current. Looking at the vertices that lead to C, which is only A, notice that 11 plus 4 is 15. So we mark A as 15, meaning if we follow this path, A is 15 units from G. We mark C as visited. And since 12 is less than 15, vertex B is now current. Only vertex A leads to B. And since 12 plus 1 is 13, which is less than 15, we replace 15 with 13, giving us our shortest path. So B is now visited, and we're done. So the shortest path from A to G is 13 units, and that path would be A to B, B to D, D to E, and finally, E to G. This is an example of Dijkstra's method of finding the shortest path. I hope you found this helpful.